class. To be able to start our mod, we are going to have topic 36, which is using scientific notation, multiplying and dividing numbers in scientific notation, which is lesson 8.4. Scientific notation. I thought we were in math. Well, it is called scientific because scientists and physicists often use it to make computations easier. Essentially, scientific notation is used to make very big or very small numbers easier to write and work with. Here's an example. The mass of the Earth is about 5.97 times 10 to the 24th power kilogram. If we are not going to use the scientific notation, it would then be written as 5970 and 21 other zeros. See how tedious that is and how inconvenient? Another example follows. An estimate for the average mass of a human cell is about 10 raised to the negative 9 power grams. If we did not use scientific notation, we would write the average mass of a human cell as 1 over 1 million. Or in its decimals equivalent, 0.00000001. A number is written in scientific notation if it is in the form A times 10 to the nth power, where A is going to be between 1 through 9, inclusively, and N is an element of the integer system, of the system of integers. So when N is positive, the number gets large. When n is negative, the number gets small. It doesn't indicate that the number is negative, okay? The exponent n represents how far the decimal point moves, not how many zeros they are. Take note of that. Now, you might be wondering, why do we need to learn scientific notation? When numbers are written in scientific notation, it is easier for us to compare these numbers and calculate with them. Just like in the previous examples. Okay, so let's work with the following practice questions. We're tasked to write the number 26 million into scientific notation. So we have 26 million. The decimal point is going to be found here. All right, what we'll do here is we move the decimal point so that the number will be expressed in terms of scientific notation, which is A times 10 to the n power. All right, so let's move the decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we have moved the decimal point 7 times. So that means n is 7. So to be able to write this in scientific notation, we'll say it's going to be 2.6. All right. Well, the other zeros are going to be insignificant. So you can just simply say 2.6 times 10 to the 7th power. All right. Okay, so moving on. Write the number 0.000034 into scientific notation. Okay, so we have 0.00034. So this time the decimal point is here, next to the first zero, so we'll move it to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have moved it to the right. Now, since we have moved the decimal point to the right, the value of n is going to be negative. So that will be n is negative 5. All right. So our answer would be 3.4 times 10 to the negative 5 power. So when we move to the left, let's take note of that. So when we move to the left, n is positive. And when we're moving to the right, n is negative. Okay. Now, earlier we had the standard form written into scientific notation. This time we are going to have the scientific notation and we are tasked to write them in standard form. Okay, now if we look at the value of n in here, n is positive. So n here is 8. So to be able to write it in standard form, we will do the opposite. If earlier we move the decimal point to the left, this time we'll be moving the decimal point to the right to change it back to its standard form. Okay? So we're going to move right then. When n is positive, I'm going to move the decimal point to the right. Okay, so this tells us that 4.398, you move the decimal point 8 times to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then these empty cells will be filled with zeros. All right, and the decimal point will be here. So once again, we move the decimal point 8 times to the right because the exponent is 8. The value of n is 8. So our answer would then be 439,800,000. Okay. All right. Okay, another example. We write the scientific notation of the number 76.4 times 10 to the negative 6 power into standard form. Now, n is negative here. What's the value of n? It is negative 6. So, when n is negative, move to the left. Okay, so you will then have 76.4. You're going to move to the left 6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the decimal point will be there. And we will end up having zeros for these empty cells. Okay. So our answer would then be 0.1. zero 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 7 6 4. All right. Okay, so we have a word problem in here. Given that x is equal to 6.3 times 10 to the 6th power, and y is 2.8 times 10, calculate the following. Give your answers in scientific notation. A times 10 raised to the n power, where a is between 1 through 9 and n belongs to the, is an element of an integer. Okay, so here we are tasked to multiply x and y, so that will then be x is 6.3, so we'll say 6.3 times 10 to the 6th power, and we're tasked to multiply by y, which is 2.8 10 to the 10th power. So the first step in here is to group, okay, is to group the a values. The a values are 6.3, okay, and 2.8. All right, and then whenever we multiply with the same base, we add the exponents. So the exponents are 6 and 10. So that would then be 6 plus 10. Now multiplying 6.3 times 2.8 will have 17.64 times 10 to the 16th power. Now, if you observe, it is not yet written in a times 10 to the n power form because the number here is 17.64. Okay, so the whole number part will need to be between 1 through 9. So we will need to move the decimal point one time to the left. Okay. So moving the decimal point one time to the left will mean 1.764. And what do we say when we move the decimal point to the left? In trying to change the standard into scientific notation, do we move the decimal? Do we increase or decrease the value of n? Okay, so look at this. 17.64 changes into 1.764. So when we move the decimal point to the left, it's going to be like this. When we move the decimal point to the left in this instance, we are n is positive, that means we're adding 1. Isn't it? Okay, we're going to add 1. So moving to the left, n is positive and we are adding 1. We're going to add 1 to our n value. So this will be times 10 to the 17th power. Okay, so that will be our answer. Next, we are going to divide. All right, so we're going to divide 6.3 times 10 to the 6th power by 2.8 times 10 to the 10th power. All right. So we are going to divide 6.3 by 2.8. And then, since we are dividing with the same base, this time we will be subtracting the the exponents. All right. So 6.3 divided by 2.8 will give us 2.25 times 10 to the negative 4th power. Now, since this is now written, the whole number part is written as 2. It's between 1 through 9. So this will be our final answer. Okay. All right. So that ends today's lesson.